Hello students, I am Dr. Seema Rana from Department of Asian Culture, Shia PG College, Lucknow. And today my video is on Second Anglo-Burma War 1852. And on First Anglo-Burma War 1824 to 26 has already been uploaded on this YouTube channel. And as we see that the Second Anglo-Burma War took place in 1852. And the First Anglo-Burma War was in 1824 to 1826. So there is a long gap of 16 years in two wars. There must be a lot of developments and a lot of factors responsible for the Second Anglo-Burma War. So what we can see, I'm going to discuss in this video the main factors and the immediate cause. What was responsible for the Second Burma War. And the factors responsible for Second War, among it, it is a six factors were there. The teak forest, that is the main factor you can say, Tenasserim and Arakan, which British occupied after First Anglo-Burma War, King of Awa or the Burmese monarch, you can say, Lord Dalhousie, the Governor General of East India Company, and Treaty of Yendabu, when the First Anglo-Burma War ended with this treaty. So now let us discuss the first. Lord Dalhousie was a Governor General, and his thirst for gaining control and expansion, and the desire for the commercial interest also, for the trading communities, and for the strategic purpose also. So he was very much thirsty for the expansion of his empire. Now, if we talk about Arakan and Tenasserim, which was under British possession after First Anglo-Burma War, Arakan took in possession solely for the purpose of naval station, and it was not vulnerable. And it was not economically profitable also, but due to its strategic importance, if British would retain it, they would be having a control on Bay of Bengal. So they just decided to retain Arakan at any cost, and Bentinck was given responsibility to develop Arakan, economically rich. And he did by promoting the dense rice cultivation in Arakan. And if you talk about Tenasserim was very much isolated. You can say that in geography, in map, it is a tail of the Burma. And it was very much far from the Calcutta, and it cannot be easily, only by the sea route it can be reached. So it was very much difficult for the British to retain it, and many of the commissioners of Tenasserim and British motive was to just sell it back to Burma or just give it to Siam. But none of the Siam or Burma was interested to buy Tenasserim. And but Tenasserim was, one feature was that the commissioner Blundell developed a very strong military base, an independent military base also. He was very much eager to lodge a war with Burma, but he could not get permission from the Britishers commissioners board of control, and he always claimed also some of the islands to raise the revenue along the river Salween, which was at the border of Burma and Tenasserim. And the other thing is, the most important thing you can say, the factor was teakwood conflict. Teakwood conflict is that Burma was very much rich in teakwood, and teakwood is very much valuable for the navy purpose also, for the merchants, for the shipbuilding, ship repair, and the greed was more and more for the teakwood. And teakwood was floated down the river Salween, and when it reached to the Burmese shore, merchants paid salvage to it then, and the chain, there was a chain or a rope was strength, and it was there was a news that the Burmese cut that rope, and the British merchants just complained, blundered to set a guard and ensure that Burmese do not cut the rope, and this issue became a very burning issue, and British regarded as a Burmese theft, and so the British imposed 10% duty in return, and this salvage duty was replaced by the duty, and then British regarded themselves as the injured party, and so the British also burned village near it, and salvage fees replaced duty. That was a very you can say burning issue of between the two border conflict between Burma and Tenasserim, and he continued the cause of misunderstanding in frontier conflict. Some merchants had a tie-up with the Mattaban officials and who stole teaks from competitors, and British continuously going on the violation of forest rules, and it resulted in huge deforestation of teak forest, because they just cut down the trees and sell and make more money. Or by mid-century we can see that teak forest was exhausted, and just because of the British merchants, lot of merchants cutting teak wood, deforestation of teak forests, merchants started penetrating deeper and deeper in Burma. Now, before going to the next factor, I just want to explain it with the help of a map to you. And with the help of a map, if we see that this portion was already with the British, and this portion is also with the British. This is Arakan, and this is Tenasserim, and only only the effort was that the British was not having the position of this portion, this dark portion which is in dark pink color. So the merchants, or you can say the Britishers, they were just could not the trade route by road or by road on this from this region to get on to Tenasserim. So they have to just adopt by sea route, and sea route have to take to this. So that is why the Calcutta was very much far and the Tenasserim was left aloof. So the main thing is those, and now I would say that the Rangoon lies also in this region. So the main war was with this region only. And now Rangoon was the important trading center. And if we see Rangoon, that all the trade routes from the Rangoon went to other Southeast Asian countries and others beside, and it was an important seaport also, and it was a very profitable sea trade center which was got backing by the Burmese monarch. And beside Burmese, there was small number of Indians, European merchants also who resided over there, and they had a trade with the shipbuilding, local Burmese products, and the main thing was the illicit export of the precious gems which was found in Burma. And if we talk about Burma, maintained a restrictive trade policy, and which the British could not digest this restrictive trade policy, because British merchants and the European merchants always was in favor of free trade policy. In 1846, the British trade community tried their best to bring the Rangoon in British Indian orbit, because it was an important sea trade also, seaport, and just because it was also the connection between the Arakan and the Tenasserim, so the whole region will be in between. And from Rangoon, they can have the free trade route to other parts also. And if we see Rangoon, this route from Rangoon is going to other part, to China and other part of the Southeast Asian countries also. And merchants claimed that Burmese were very much adopting monopolistic trade practices, and they were not in favor of free trade, that the European and British merchants could not digest. And many merchants complained to Calcutta Council also that the monarch harsh behavior of Tharavadi and monarch of Tharavadi and Awa. And the most popular complaints or plea which Calcutta Council received was for merchant lower crisp plea. It became most popular, and he was arrested many times for bullion smuggling. And shepherd pilot Captain Harold Lewis was also among the main complainants. They complained in Calcutta Council. Precious gems which was found in Burma, smuggling was a continuous problem for the along the border. And in 1847, Rangoon governor was removed with the allegations of enforcement of bullion export prohibition. Now, if we see, these were all the factors. And if we talk about Yandabu Treaty, the Yandabu Treaty went as a dead letter, you can say, and it was not followed by British. And English demanded, when the governor of Rangoon was charged from Shepherd and Lewis Company, the penalty or compensation of the smuggling of the bullion or gun, and the complaint went to the Calcutta Council. So the British demanded cash from the Burma Darbar, which is the immediate situation which ignited the Second Anglo-Burma War. That the English demanded the Burma Darbar that the compensation here, the UM penalty you charge from the Shepherd and the Lewis Company. And as in Treaty of Yandabu, it was written that 50 of the residents could reside and have a free trade, and they can have the residence also, they can buy land also in Rangoon. And it was not obeyed. The governor was not of Rangoon was not in favor of this. And no English, as there was no English resident at the court. Dalhousie named the maritime officer Lambert to go to Rangoon and ask the governor to return the sum charged to with Shepherd and Lewis Company. Lambert charged the governor of Rangoon, and with a very violence acts, they charged with the governor of Rangoon. And he also sent letters to representative and of Britishers also, and to British and the Burmese monarch also, that to answer within five weeks about all these acts of the governor of Rangoon. And he didn't get the appropriate answers from not even from British and not from Calcutta Council and not from the Burmese monarch also. And the governor was changed, but the Burmese monarch changed the governor, and the English, or you can say British, were guaranteed of appropriate investigation into the entire issue. And at that point, a nomination, you can say, and the representation was sent by the British to meet the new local, governor, which was appointed by the monarch. But the new governor neglected to meet the representation sent by British. They stood against the sun in the sunlight for 10 to 15 minutes. And then also the governor neglected to meet them. And the Britishers accept it as a very disrespect to themselves. And they announced that, and when the governor was asked why the reason not to meet them, and he said that he was sleeping and he was resting. And the when the representation came to meet them, and the Lamberts didn't acknowledge this clarification of the governor as genuine, and he requested that he look for the and he requested for acquittal of the Shepherd and Lewis company and pay the compensation back in cash. And then after his disrespect and the governor not meeting him, he just expanded the interest of cash. He just increased the interest of cash. And further to incite, he ignited the Burmese for war. Lambert bought the imperial vessel that was a very royal ship of yellow ship, which was viewed as a holy boat. And the Burmese governor said that all the requests what British made will be fulfilled, but only you just leave the royal ship. And at last, the English requested the governor of Rangoon ought to be moved. Again, they request that you just change the governor. And the ruler of Burma, Munar, to apologize to Burma in return and pay 1 lakh to the English, to the British before end of April 1852. But on 30th till 30th April, the British did not get any reply from the Burmese monarch. And at that point, when no answer was received from Van Rop, no reply was received, the English armed force was dispatched to Rangoon, and they were, and the war was proclaimed by the English, by the British. So the war started. And what was the results of the Second Anglo-Burma War? That England, the British occupied Rangoon, Basin, Prome and Pegu by October 1852. And that is called as a Lower Burma. The entire Lower Burma passed into the hands of the British. Whereas if you talk about Dalhousie, Dalhousie had no desire to pursue the war in Upper Burma, because he just wanted to wait for some time for negotiation with the British or Burmese monarch. But Burma refused to accept any treaty. Therefore, Pegu, Lower Burma, was annexed to the British Empire simply after the proclamation in December 1852. And if we talk about this, this pink region, this full pink region, with the area which shaded in pink color is went hands into the British. You can say this Pegu and Rangoon, Tongu, this basin, this full region has gone, and which was the most desirable, which was more desirable for the British, because it was a it was a connection also from Arakan and Tenasserim, and as Rangoon was an important sea trade center for the European merchants, Indian merchants, and it was having a direct trade route to the different countries of the Southeast Asia. So now this is over. Thank you, students. And you can say that this PPT was made only for the purpose of e-learning. It does not have any commercial use. And I claim that the photos I used in this PPT was from the Wikipedia, and the references what I used, the books, is Origin of Second Anglo-Burmese War by Oliver B. Pollack and The Eastern Frontier of British India by Anil Chandra Banerjee. Thank you.